What do solar panels cost currently? That's the most frequently asked question when it comes to solar panels, closely followed by which specific solar panel should I buy? And honestly, those are also the two most crucial questions when it comes to solar panels, because if both align perfectly, well, then you've already done a lot right. Let's first take a look at what a solar panel really costs. A single solar panel currently costs between 77 and 165 euros. Yes, you heard right. The price range is really quite wide, and it depends on the type, the performance, and the manufacturer you choose. Most modules currently have a power output of 390 to 460 watts peak, but the 500 watt peak modules are really taking over the market now. I was at Intersolar, and the manufacturers are really stepping up. Big news is coming soon. And that means you need roughly 2 to 3 modules per kilowatt peak, so 1 kilowatt peak equals 1000 watts. To achieve that, 2 to 3 modules. For those wondering, what exactly is watt peak? Let me quickly explain that for you. Watt peak is the maximum power output that a solar module can deliver under standard test conditions. And because neither my roof nor your roof are optimally oriented, unfortunately, since we simply have different roof alignments, maybe the weather has an influence or they're soiling, in reality, you simply end up with less, or rather, less light coming in. So maybe as a comparison, a car has 300 horsepower on paper, but that doesn't mean you're always driving 250 kilometers per hour. So what modules are available now, and what do you get for your money? Before we clarify that, we first need to understand what efficiency is, because it plays a crucial role in every type of solar module. The higher the efficiency of your solar module, the better, of course, the electricity yield on the same area will be. This means your solar module should have the highest possible efficiency, and we're already reaching values of up to 25% in some cases. That was the highlight of Intersolar, but currently, solar modules are ranging between 22 and 25. Anything below 22%, I wouldn't even bother considering. It's already outdated technology by now. So you see, watt peak is one thing, but the efficiency truly demonstrates how effectively your module can harness the sun's energy. It's a bit like cooking, maybe. So the ceramic cooktop takes forever to heat up, while induction delivers immediately in comparison. And a module that is highly efficient simply delivers a greater output. And that is undoubtedly a significant advantage, particularly when considering repowering and replacing your older solar modules. And to extract more performance, essentially you can say there are two types of solar modules, monocrystalline and polycrystalline. That describes the cell technology, meaning the material that actually generates the electricity. And monocrystalline solar panels are composed of a single silicon crystal. They have a very high efficiency, usually look much more aesthetically pleasing, being completely black, for example, and are great if you have a roof with limited space, because you want to get the most out of it. And polycrystalline modules, these are made up of multiple crystals, often recognizable by this bluish color. They're cheaper, but less efficient. Honestly, they're rarely built anymore. Then there are also different types of monocrystalline modules, namely glass-glass modules. And they simply have a glass layer on both sides, are more durable, more fire-resistant, sturdier, but also heavier. Then there are the glass film modules. There's glass in the front, plastic in the back. They're a bit lighter, slightly cheaper perhaps. So glass-glass has really caught up, almost in the same price range, but the glass film modules aren't quite as durable. Then there are bifacial solar modules, which capture light from both the front and the back, and are especially interesting for open areas. So for example, solar fences or for carport roofs, where light really does come from both sides. On a tiled roof on top, it's generally the case that very little light is reflected. So it doesn't really do much for you there. To sum it up, you could say the cell type provides the power, and the module design determines how well that performance is maintained over the years. Which module suits whom? Now you might be thinking, thanks Niels, I get it, but I'm still unsure which module I should actually buy. And honestly, I totally get you, because I'm currently asking myself the same question. We've bought a house, the roof is being renovated, and a PV system is supposed to go on it, and I'm still unsure which solar module to choose. So, here's a little tip for you. Jot down a few notes, ask yourself some questions to gain a clearer sense of which module might be the most suitable option for you. So, kind of like a mini wish list, for example, how much space do you have on the roof? Do you have limited space? Then you'll need modules with high efficiency and a higher watt peak. With smaller modules, arrange them differently. Second tip, how important is design? So if you want it to look really stylish, then in my opinion, full black is a good choice, but that's very individual. Thirdly, do you want to go the affordable route or invest for the long term? So should it be a low budget solution for now, or do you prefer premium quality with an extended warranty? Fourthly, how long should the system last and what does it need to withstand? Are you in an area with a lot of hail, snow load, or wind loads? Then definitely take a look at glass-glass modules. If you have surfaces like carports, garages, or fences, it's definitely worth considering bifacial modules. And sixth, how much electricity do you actually aim to produce? High demand? Then you'll definitely need high-performance modules or simply a much larger surface area. Seventh, how much do warranties and service matter? No-name modules, they usually cut corners on both. Brands offer warranties of up to 25, 30 years, and my tip here is to look for big names, big companies that actually have substantial market shares, as they'll most likely remain in the market and stay accessible to you in the future. Feel free to write in the comments what's important to you for the solar module, manufacturer, design, price, what you focus on. I'd be really curious to know because we'll have to make a decision pretty soon as well. Let's get to the key terms. When you dive into offers, you'll inevitably come across some technical terms that are important, but many people don't fully grasp what they mean. Which is why I'll explain them briefly so you can confidently join in the next consultation. So, performance degradation simply means that every solar module gradually loses some of its efficiency over time. Good solar modules lose only about 0.25 to 0.5% per year. Poor modules lose significantly more. Over the years, that really adds up quite significantly. After 25 years, it can mean maintaining 80% performance versus dropping to just 60%. And then we have the performance warranty. Many manufacturers guarantee that your solar module will still have at least 80% or 85% of its original output after 25 years. That's a key benchmark. Definitely take a close look at this. The manufacturer's warranty guarantees that if the module is faulty or has a production defect, it will be replaced. And depending on the manufacturer, it varies between 10, 25, or even 30 years. Honestly, that's quite a long time. And the question is whether the manufacturers will even still be around by then. That's why I look for big manufacturers. That was my tip earlier. The temperature coefficient is rarely considered, but it's completely underestimated because it shows how much your module loses performance in the heat. The lower the value, the better, especially for south-facing roofs that get really hot in the summer. You naturally still want good performance then. Snow and hail resistance are essential. It may seem minor, but it's absolutely crucial, especially in Germany. If you live in the south or at higher altitudes, for example, the modules should also be certified for heavy snow loads and hail impact. That's also stated in the data sheet and is a matter of warranty. A topic I hear about very often, where I get messages or it's brought up in the community, is repowering. That means many started 15, 20 years ago by installing a PV system on their roof. Back then, it was ideal, but now the real question that arises is, what comes next? The feed-in tariff is approaching its end, or the amortization has already been fully achieved. And the old modules versus the new ones are really no longer up to par nowadays. State of the art, so to speak. And of course, when you look at it today, the offerings on the market, more powerful modules, higher efficiency, and even sleeker, the idea naturally comes up, man, I could just remove the old modules and replace them with new ones. I'd have the same area and could generate significantly more electricity. But does that really make sense? On one hand, of course, you get more power, use your roof more efficiently, the area you already had covered, and that's a huge plus. On the other hand, though, you have to invest again, and your whole amortization calculation starts over from zero. Don't forget the issue of sustainability. The question here is it really necessary? My tip is, honestly, take a look at what the replacement costs. How much more power do you get for it? Do you even need the extra power? And what if you just let the whole thing continue as it is? Where was your focus 10 years ago? And now? Self-consumption or feeding into the grid?